我们那边春节的话会杀猪。
杀猪？
对，但是我觉得话猪非常伤心啊，非常悲伤。
为什么呀？
因为他们会发出一种很凄厉的声音。
那你模仿一下呗。
你给我一刀。
Good morning, guys. Welcome back to Beijing and another episode of Imperial Chow. Now, over here, everyone's already started their preparations for Chinese New Year. The Chinese New Year, or Spring Festival, and all the other festivals in China, are all determined by the lunar calendar. So when you're trying to figure out when that is on the Gregorian calendar, well, it changes every year. And this year, New Year's Eve, or Chuxi, lands on the 31st of January. So normally each year before everyone leaves, I always try to get together with mates and colleagues to have a big dinner to celebrate. And today we've come to Laodongjie Shuanrou, which is a traditional Beijing hot pot, different to the shabu shabu hot pot that I had last time. And today I've got some mates coming over. It's all gonna be in high spirits. More importantly, there's gonna be lots of lush food. So I'm gonna go upstairs and start ordering and I'll see you there.给大家介绍一下，我们今天为一个北京朋友，花敏，花敏，你不是北京人吗？
对，我是北京人。
那到春节的时候，你最喜欢什么？怎么过呀？
我最喜欢就是，每天上下班的路程的时候，像平时的话都是人特别多。
你在北京住哪儿啊？
我住在丰台。
十号线对吗？
啊，对，十号线人特别多，但是像最近的话，很多都回家了，特别少。我每天一上车的时候都有座位。
对，座位。那才好了。
对，
如果每天可以像这样就行了。
对，平时可能不太行，平时北京人太多了。
是不是？
对。
然后这个帅哥他叫呱呱，哎，呱呱，你是哪人？
我是安徽的。
安徽的，你来北京多少年了？
六年了。
那到春节你每年都要回去吗？
就是按照正常情况来讲的话，是应该每年都要回家的，因为一年都在外面。但是这两年因为疫情就没回去。
那你在那边有什么传统吃的东西吗？
就是我们家那边我记得比较深刻的还是那个炸丸子。
炸丸子是什么？
就是他会用面去，然后包着馅儿，差不多一个就包这么大，差不多类似于这种虾滑这个差不多这么大一个东西，然后一锅放到锅里去炸。炸出来之后就是丸子，就是金黄金黄的。
辣吗？
你要辣的话可以里面加辣椒加胡椒。
那安徽能吃辣吗？
分人吧，我是比较能吃辣，但有人不是很能吃辣。
对，有意思有意思、以后有机会就吃吧。
对，因为那个就是还挺好吃的，然后也可以当零食吃那个东西，对，比较健康。
旁边这个哥们儿叫阿琛，他来自湖南。你是湖南哪儿的？
湖南张家界。
张家界。 到春节的时候有什么特色吗？
我们那边春节的话会杀猪。
杀猪？
对，但是我觉得的话，猪非常伤心啊，非常悲伤。
为什么呀？
因为他们会发出一种很凄厉的声音。
那你模仿一下呗。
你给我一刀。
喂。谁杀他呢？
就是家里的长辈，像我们年轻人不会杀，就是三十多、四十多的一些叔叔啊那些会杀。
多大的？
大概三个成年人的重量吧，四五百斤。
哇塞，那这些血和肉是干什么的呢？
会把它混合起来做成那种香肠。
啊，我们英国苏格兰也有个血肠，叫 black pudding， 黑布丁。
黑布丁啊？
嗯。
那我有机会吃一下吗？
没问题，下次带你去吧。
好啊。
Cheers。然后这位朋友叫小驴，你是天津的对吧？
天津的。
那到春节的时候有什么该吃的吗？
啊，在我们那儿可能会吃，在你们认知里叫年糕，但是在我们那儿叫丝糕，类似这样的一个东西。然后呢，它是拿，就是咱们那个灶台，就是那个特别大的那个铁锅，拿那个去蒸一个，然后它是蒸那么大一个，然后到时候切成一块一块的。
那是吃甜的吗？
对，它是甜的，然后是小米面的，上面还有枣。然后这个东西，怎么说呢，在我们那儿也算是主食，就跟馒头一样。
所以这个也可以吃完辣的，吃完咸的再吃这个吗？还是可以？
混着吃，就是当主食吃。
哇塞！
不跟你们一样，你们最后吃甜点，但是我们就直接就着菜，然后就着这个就吃了。
有意思。但我很喜欢吃枣，我应该吃这个，跟发糕有点像，对吗？
对。怎么说呢？这个，
上周吃的河间那个卤肉火烧，
是的，那是我们的。
那你们到春节也吃卤肉吗？
啊，不，我们春节的时候不会吃驴肉火烧的，我们就吃饺子。
吃饺子，那会不会有卤肉馅的饺子？
不会有驴肉馅的，我们就是猪肉的或者羊肉的。
啊，那我听说有的地方包饺子会放银币，你们会吗？
对，我们也会那样的。就比如，50个饺子里面，我们就放3-5个饺子。代表着是来年大富大贵嘛。
啊，哎，那我们晚一点去饺子吧。
好的。
好。Okay guys, we all hope you have a fantastic New Year of the Tiger. 祝大家新年快乐，虎年大吉。Probably know that the color red is very auspicious here in China, and especially over a spring festival, you'll see lots of red clothes, red scarves, red lanterns, and you'll also see red envelopes or red packets containing money. And normally, we give these to children or people younger than us, but you can give them to your parents, to other family members, and to friends. And today, I want to buy some because I want to give some lucky money to the colleagues who help me out with the camera sometimes. Okay, so I've bought two hongbaos, two red envelopes, and I want to talk a little bit about the characters that are on them, so I think they're quite interesting. This one says Ya Sui Bao. Now, Ya means pressure, and Sui is your age. And so the reason why we give them to children is because parents want to keep them at a young age. They don't want them to grow up too fast, they want to keep them young and cute. And this one is Fu, and Fu means good fortune. It's a character that you'll see a lot of, especially at Spring Festival, stuck on doors, windows, and walls, and you normally see it upside down. And the reason for this is because upside down is Dao, and Dao also means arrive. So if you stick your Fu upside down, then good fortune will arrive. Okay, so almost finished for the day. Me and my mate decided to come down to the dumpling restaurant because we thought, well, we're gonna be eating a lot of dumplings over the next week, so why not start early? Now this place is a great little place. Huge portions, tasty filling, and it's pretty cheap. Plus, I've got a little gift for my mate.
Programme.
其实我去了两三次表演，去那边说唱，在哪里？我忘了那个地方叫什么，但是在市中心。哎 ，Steven， 因为你嘴尖，帮我拍了视频，我给你准备了一个红包啊，新年快乐！不要了吧，太客气了。没事没事，收吧。啊，吃吃，先吃嘛。 Now, me and Stephen actually come here quite a lot for lunch because it's just below our office. And this place specializes in jiaozi or dumplings. They've got about 10 different fillings and they've also got a selection of about 20 different cold dishes. But today, we've just stuck with the classics. We've got pork and onion and egg and chives. And people eat dumplings all through the year, but especially on Qixi, especially on Chinese New Year's Eve, family gets together and at midnight, when the new year replaces the old year, that's when you eat jiaozi. There's another homonym at play here. So jiaozi, it means to replace, and jiaozi is dumplings. So that's why we eat it at midnight. Also, there's some more symbolism going on. Each dumpling, the shape resembles those silver and gold ingots. So, you know, you're eating gold, you're probably gonna get quite wealthy in the year to come. If you really want to find out more about dumplings, make sure you check out my previous episode where I went to Mr. Shur's dumpling restaurant, because there, he takes it to a whole new level. Now, I've also got my chili oil and vinegar dipping sauce, which I love. Adds a new flavor. Some families even go to the point where they clean money and they'll put it in maybe one or two dumplings. So out of 60 or 70 dumplings, everyone's around the table trying to choose the one that's got the money, because if you do, that means you're gonna have a very prosperous year coming up. Hey guys, thank you for making it this far in the video, and I really hope you enjoyed today's episode. Wherever you're from, I hope you have a fantastic Chinese New Year's. Maybe you know a dumpling restaurant near you, why not hit it up? And if you don't, why not look online on how to make dumplings, have some friends or family around and have some fun. You might receive some lucky money. If you did enjoy today's episode, please consider subscribing and give me a likes up. And if you haven't caught our previous episodes, you can catch up here. Leave me a comment down below on what's your favorite dumpling, what's your favorite filling. And next time, I'll see you in the year of the tiger.